Welcome to the Marvelous Designer in CFX series. For part 3, we will be looking at interacting between multiple simulations. The character in the second and third shots moves aside some hanging baggage as he moves through the tent. In the last shot, the character opens the tent to walk outside. The interactions between the character and bags and later with the tent flap must be done in the following way so as not to change the point count of the finished costume. Adding any cloth geometry will make the point caches not work with the completed setup we did in the last tutorial. These bags are meant to look filled with something, so use positive pressure on the bag patterns to puff them out. Select half of every bag, right-click, and solidify. This is to help keep the bag's shape as the character moves them aside. They have been pinned at the top to keep them hanging in place. Once this cluster of bags looks right, they can be copied and edited slightly to make a bunch of bags. Rotate them and delete parts as desired. Once the bags are placed according to what looks good from the camera, the character avatar and the inner structure of the tent avatar are imported. This is done separately as the tent structure is an OBJ and the character is an alembic with motion. When adding avatars, choose Import, Add from the menu. Set the avatar's skin offset to 9. The reason for this is to give space for when the clothes are simmed against the pre-simulated bags. Once this is simmed and looks good, export the bags as an alembic. This alembic will be textured later with Substance Painter and used directly in the shot. Open the main character project and import the animated character specific for this shot. It is important to remember that the animated character should start from the A pose and same position as the character in the main character project. This saves refitting or repositioning the garment on the character, which can take a lot of time. All that is needed after import is to reattach the pins to the new avatar. Next, import the hanging baggage alembic previously simmed. Again, use Import, Add, Alembic for this. Set the static friction and kinetic friction to 0 so the clothing does not stick to the hanging baggage. Simulate. Once happy with the results, export a PC2 cache for 3ds Max or Maya cache for Maya and plug into the MD driver and MD cloth setup in the last tutorial. This same method is used for the third shot and the final shot. For the final shot, the character needs to open up the tent flap and exit. Again, the animated character is added to the original tent project. The skin offset of the character for this shot is set to 12. The tent flap itself has a fabric thickness setting of 50. Because only the tent flap being opened is needed for the clothes simulation, the tent has been removed and made double-sided, and then exported from 3ds Max. Then it is imported as an added avatar to the main character project in Marvelous Designer. Both static friction and kinetic friction are again set to zero, so the clothes do not stick to the tent flap. Finally, to simulate the strong wind outside the tent, the wind controller is animated to reflect this. Set the wind strength to zero. In order to animate parameters of the wind controller, the key activate box must be checked beneath the strength setting. At frame 60, add a key to keep the wind at zero until then. At frame 230, change wind strength to 700 and add a key. This will cause the wind to gradually increase in strength as the character exits the tent and steps into the full force of the wind. All these settings for wind strength are the result of tests done previously to see how strong the wind should be. Simulate the garment, and when happy with results, export a PC2 cache for use in Threads Max or Maya cache for use in Maya. Lastly, Marvelous Designer has recently added multiple wind controllers. These can be used to create many varied and interesting wind effects where desired. This hood is being animated by two wind controllers. Both are individually animated. In order to make an additional wind controller, right-click on it and select Duplicate. Remember when animating the attributes of the wind controller to make sure the appropriate key activate box is checked. This concludes part 3 of this series.